Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and to another color grading tutorial. Today we're going to look at how to correct DJI Mavic 3 footage. Before we get started, I want to give a special thanks to Dasun who sent me this footage. He shot this footage on his DJI Mavic 3 and he shared it with me so that I can create this tutorial. So I'm going to show you three ways to color correct your DJI Mavic 3 footage. This first method is by using the free D-Log M to Rec 709 LUT that DJI provides on their website. I've linked it down below in the description so you can go and download it. I'm not going to show you how to install LUTs in this tutorial. I've already made another video for that, which I'll also link down in the description. So if you don't already have this LUT, pause this video, go download the LUT, install it, and then come back to this video. So real quick, let's just set it up. In this first node, I'm going to bring in the D-Log M to Rec 709 LUT. So I'm going to go over to my LUTs folder. And wherever you installed the DJI Mavic 3 D-Log to Rec 709 LUT, just go ahead and drag that into that node. We can close our LUTs panel. Now that we have the LUT in this node here, we can rename it. Then I'm gonna hit Shift S to create a node upstream, which will be before the LUT node. And I'll rename this Primaries. And this node here is where we're gonna make all of our adjustments. Usually, because I like to have a little bit more control over things, I'll create two more parallel nodes. And this is where I'll do my white balance and my saturation. And I like to do that so I can disable them individually and see what each adjustment is doing. I'm just gonna use one node for this tutorial. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna adjust my contrast. I like to keep as much detail in the shadows as possible while still trying to keep them as deep as possible. I'm just gonna mess with the contrast a little bit so I'm getting some of that detail back in the shadows. So I'll go too far and then come back. And I'm liking that right there. Another thing that I always like to do is make sure I'm keeping all the details of my highlights. So I'll go down here to this highlights control and I'll roll it down some. And this is a great control to use when you wanna bring back some detail in the highlights without affecting the shadows. So now that I've got a decent contrast, I'm gonna go ahead and adjust my saturation a little bit. And I've made a video on different ways that you can adjust saturation. I'm gonna go with the simple saturation adjustment here. And I'll go far, too far, and then I'll bring it back some. And I'm liking this right here. When you're adjusting saturation and you're looking at the vectorscope, you want to imagine that you have these straight lines connecting these boxes here. And I have mine set to show me 75% saturation and 100% saturation. So if I'm crossing this imaginary line here between these boxes, I know that I'm probably oversaturated. If I'm crossing these imaginary lines between these outside boxes, which represent 100% saturation, then I definitely know that it's oversaturated and I'm clipping. But as we can see here, I'm well within those bounds and I'm not clipping at all, and the image is looking pretty vibrant. We are adjusting primary, so what I would also do in this node is adjust the white balance, but I feel that Dasun did a good job with the white balance. If I zoom in a little bit on the vectorscope, you can see here that the vectorscope is pretty well balanced. It is pretty centered, so I don't feel like I need to adjust the white balance. But if you are adjusting the white balance, go ahead and do it in this node using the temperature and tint controls or the offset wheel. As you're adjusting your contrast and your saturation, just keep an eye on your vectorscope and your waveform, whatever scopes you're using, to make sure you're not losing any detail in your highlights or in your shadows, and also to make sure you're not oversaturated. Remember that with color correcting your footage, you're not looking to create anything unnatural looking. You just want to get it to a natural looking scene. Now I'm going to show you how to manually color correct your Mavic 3 footage. And I have this little node tree set up here, and it's basically three nodes. So you can do this in three nodes like I'm doing here, or again, you can do it in one node. And then I have this noise reduction node here. So I'll just deactivate this node because we don't really need it. I just put it here as a reminder for you that if you need to add a noise reduction node, that you want to do it before your primaries. I'll go ahead and reset these nodes. And this is our original Mavic 3 D-Log M footage. So the first thing we're going to adjust is our contrast. So I'll go to my contrast node, then I'm going to go over to my luminance curve and I'm going to click on it so that it unlinks from the RGB curves. Why am I doing this? Because if I adjust this curve while they're linked together, I'm going to be adjusting the saturation. And I don't want to do that in this curve. I want to control the saturation using a different tool and by itself. So I'll unlink this and then I'll go ahead and apply contrast to my image. What I'll do is click on these three dots here. Now I'll go to editable splines. Now when I click on these anchors, these little anchors will come up and I can create a really nice smooth S curve. And I'll bring this up to right around here. And then I'll click on this anchor here, which will bring up this other anchor, and I can bring down my shadows. and I'll leave that there for now. I'll go back up to the to this top end and I'll keep adjusting. Then I'll go back here, keeping an eye on this area here. Also looking at my scopes to make sure this doesn't go too dark. Then I'll go back up to my highlights. And we'll leave it around there. Next up, I want to add some saturation because this is looking very gray and dull. So I'll go over to my saturation. I'm just going to crank up the saturation control all the way. I've cranked it up all the way and it's still not as saturated as I would like. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to my curves adjustments. I'm going to go over to my luminance versus saturation curve. Then I'm going to toggle these two anchors here and I'll drag them over here. And then I'll bring up the saturation in the midtones. And what this is doing is it's allowing me to add saturation in the midtones. And these two controls here will allow me to take out that adjustment from the brightest parts and the darkest parts, which is great because I don't want that much color in the blackest parts of my image or in the whitest parts. This luminance versus saturation curve has the histograms turned to input. So this waveform that we can see here in the background, this is showing me where my footage is sitting and at what point this adjustment is affecting my footage. So here's where I start to get some information, and this adjustment is just past that a little bit. So I'm starting to get some saturation a little bit in my shadows and then more so here in my midtones. As I get closer to my highlights, seeing that this is my brightest part here, I'll bring over this point, making sure that it's right over the brightest parts of my image or just past that a little bit. And if I move this upper anchor here, you can see that it affects the image slightly differently depending on where I put it. And I'm liking how it's affecting the image around here. If after adding this adjustment and increasing the saturation adjustment all the way, you still feel like you would like a little bit of color in your shot, then you can go over to the color boost and bring this up a little bit. Just be careful, keep an eye on your vectorscope to make sure that you're not breaking your footage. It can be very easy to break your footage or make your footage look very unnatural if you push this color boost too much. So we're just gonna add a little bit just cause we've already added some saturation to it. And I'm just gonna increase it so I feel like I'm getting a vibrant image, but still natural. Somewhere around 8 is good enough. Again, Dasun did a good job shooting this footage, and I don't feel like this needs a white balance adjustment, but after adding some saturation, you would then adjust your white balance. And actually, you don't necessarily need to adjust the contrast first, and then the saturation, and then the white balance. It's really up to you how you go about adjusting your primaries, whether it's contrast first, or saturation first, or white balance first. Whatever you feel helps you get to a good spot for your primaries is the way to go. For most instances, adjusting my contrast and my saturation first allows me to get a good enough color separation in the shot, which makes it easier for me to gauge the white balance. But again, whatever order, whatever method works for you, go with that method. And this is our final image, color correcting it manually. For our contrast, we use this luminance curve here. For the saturation, we boosted up the saturation all the way and we added some saturation in the midtones via the luminance versus saturation curve. And then we increased our color boost a little bit just to get us to that little bit more saturation that we needed. And then for this shot, we did not need to adjust the white balance. But again, if you need to for your shot, you can use the temperature and tint controls or the offset wheel. Whatever tool you prefer to use for adjusting white balance is just fine. So a lot of colorists who use DaVinci Resolve, they know about the color space transform tool. People who shoot on DJI drones have been very confused about the D-log footage settings in the color space transform tool. And that's because if you go over to the input color space and you go down to DJI, you will find a DJI D gamut setting. And then in the input gamma, you will find a DJI D-log setting. What everyone reports, and it's been my experience as well, is that these settings work with some shots. And then for other shots, it does not work. And this is because these were built not with prosumer drones in mind, but these were created for the professional drones, like the Zen Muse and the other top of the line drones. So this will not work for your DJI D-Log M footage. There's a difference between D-Log and D-Log M. The Mavic 3, the DJI Air 2S, which is what I shoot with, or the DJI Mini, these shoot D-Log M footage. So taking a look at this shot, I'll turn off the CST node. This is our original D-Log footage. If I turn it on, it's not doing necessarily a bad job, but it's not getting us there all the way. It's changing the image a little bit. Our footage is not clipping. neither in the luminance or in our saturation. You can try setting the input gamma to DJI D-Log and see if that gives you a decent transformation. It sort of seems to depend on the lighting conditions of the shot. But after doing some experimenting and testing, I actually found another setting for the input gamma that you can use that I feel gives a better result. And that is to use the Panasonic V-Log for input gamma. And I feel like this gives me a little bit more contrast and a little better saturation. And after doing some testing with some other footage, I found it to work better across different clips than the DJI D-Log setting. So as of June 2023, the Color Space Transform tool does not have a setting for D-Log M footage, but you can use the Panasonic V-Log setting in the input gamma, and then obviously setting your output color space to Rec 709 and gamma 2.4 to create that standard broadcast conversion. And then just like I showed you in the manual correction method or in the LUT method, you would make adjustments upstream in your node graph. I'm not gonna do that here because I already showed you twice how you can go about that. And you would just do the same thing here. I have this Panasonic V-Log setting set here in the CST and I don't have any adjustments made. And I feel like this is a decent looking conversion. If there are some other settings that you've used with the Color Space Transform tool on your DJI Mavic 3 D-Log M footage, comment down below and let us know. Might benefit somebody else who's trying to use the CST node with the same footage. Also, comment down below any questions you may have, and I'll do my best to help you out. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you on the next tutorial.